So 10th class, continuing with the concept of HTML forms. Today, I'll be teaching you the concept of buttons, right? And combo box and list box. Okay. So let us start. HTML tag followed by body tag. I am taking the BG color as gray. Then I am taking the form tag. Here I am taking table tag without border. I am creating my first row. User ID. And here I am creating the text box. I am giving the name T1. Okay. Then I am taking here another password. Then I am creating the password control. Okay. And here I close my second row. So, in the two rows, I have created the user ID and password. You will be filling your user ID and password in these two boxes, right? So, here I am closing my table tag, applying the BR over here. I am using buttons today. Input type equal to submit. The use of submit button is that the form data, it gets submitted to the server. Whatever data you have filled in the form, your form will be submitted at the server page, okay, at the URL that is being provided, right? Name equal to S1, value attribute submit. Now, what is the role of value attribute of input tag? But a value attribute is used to set the initial value of the control, right? It is used to set the initial value of the control, okay? Like suppose I am giving here user ID and I am giving the value ABC12. So this value will be filled in the user ID box, right? Now, in order to create the buttons, you have two methods. Either you create buttons with the help of input tag, or you can create buttons with the help of button tag. There are two methods to create the buttons, button control, either by using the input tag, or you can create the buttons straight away by taking the button tag. Okay. Submit. So here I apply. Next button I'm going to create is reset button. Reset button is used to set the form to the default values again. It will again refresh your form so that form takes the initial default values again. Okay. Name equal to R1, value equal to reset. right? Clear? So here I'm closing the form tag. And here I close the body tag. Here I close the HTML tag. I'm going to save this coding in the documents. Form2.html. Let us see the browser view. This is my form. See here, is the browser view visible? Yes, class, is the browser view visible to everyone? So, see this. I have given the value ABC12 in the input tag while creating the text control, and the initial value is already visible in the text box. Okay. Am I clear with the value attribute? Now, if I I am entering the password, right? And if I click on the submit button, the data will be sent to the server. And if I click on the reset button, again, it will set to the initial values. The form will be reset to its default values. Suppose I am not giving the value attribute here. I am omitting this value attribute inside the text control, right? And now I try to enter the values. See here. The text box are totally blank and I have to set the values, right? Now here I have to set the values. So I enter ABC12. I enter the password. Now, if I click on the reset button, the form will be set to the default values again. Have you noticed? Yes, class. Is the role of submit and reset buttons are clear? Any doubt, any queries? Devita, Sahaj, Arpit, Imani. Is the concept of buttons clear? All right. Now, suppose you want to upload any file from your computer. You are to upload any file from your computer to the server, right? So in order to upload the file, there is one more, there is one control available in HTML forms, that is the file control. How to create the file control? I apply br here, input type equal to file, name equal to F1, and on top of it, I am giving the heading, select the file, and I apply the br over here, okay? See, as you apply the file control, the choose file button appears on the browser. When you click on this choose file button, the browsing window will appear and you can select any desirable file. You can select any desirable file and click on the open button and the file will get uploaded on the server. After clicking on the submit button. Okay. Many times you, when you fill the online form, suppose you are appearing for any online examination and the organization, whosoever has given the digital form to you, they inform you to upload your Aadhaar card file or upload your biodata or upload any other document. So you might have seen this button over there. Okay. So when you are using the file control, input type equal to file and give name to your file. I am giving the name F1. As you enter this command in your browser, you will notice a button get created with the name choose file, and you click on this button and the browsing window appears from where you can select any desirable file that you want to upload. Am I clear up till here? 10th class? Yes, students, immediately give your response if the lecture is clear up till here. Raise your thumb, all of you, so that I can have your feedback. Prabhun, please make sure whose thumb is up and whose thumb is down. Japjot Singh, no response is coming from your side. I think he is not attending the lecture. All right. Now, moving to the next concept, when we create the text control, text box, it is a single line entry. Just see this browser again. In this box, whatever you are filling, it is a single line entry. You cannot enter multiple line text in the single entry text box. Okay. So if you want to enter multiple lines, you want to store multiple lines in your form, for that we create the multi-line text box. How to create the multi-line text box? I create it here after the table tag so that it get more clear. BR text area, the tab that is used to create the multi-line box is text area. When you give the command input type equal to text, it will create single entry text box, single line text box. If you want to create the multiple line text box, the tag is text area. It has attributes rows. I am giving 10 rows or 5 rows. Columns, I am giving 10 columns. And I am giving name to it. I am giving the name T2. Okay. And close this text area. And above that, you can specify, enter the description here. Okay. Now this text area, it will create a box of 5 rows and 10 columns where you can enter text in multiple lines. Might you want to enter the paragraph? Okay, so you have to create the text area box, the multiple line box. Let me show the browser view. See this. Now here you can enter the multiple lines Okay. You can scroll through it like this. And you can enter your text. Right? So this is how you can create the multiple line box in HTML form. Okay, clear? Now, the next concept is how to create the combo box. Combo box, or you can say drop down box, or you can say select box. Actually, it is a box where you have different alternatives and you can select any relevant option of your choice from the given options. Okay. So in order to create the drop down box, HTML forms provide us a special tag that is called select tag. Okay. So I am going to create the combo box before the submit button. Use select tag in order to create the combo box, and the attribute of select tag is name. I am giving the name S1. Okay. Clear? And above that, I am giving the heading choose string. Now inside the select tag, you have to create the various options that you want for your drop down box. Okay. And how to create the different type of options, for that you have to take option tag. You have to take option tag. Option tag has the attribute value. And I am providing here the value commerce. Option tag closes. Now another option you can give as many options as you want. Like I am giving here science. Okay. Then I am giving the option arts. Then I am giving the option humanities. I'm giving the option mass media. Okay. So these are all the options that I want to be appearing in my drop-down box or combo box. So here I close the select tag. Okay. I apply BR here. Then I apply the center tag so that buttons should appear in the center of the browser window. And here I close the center tag. Right? Now see here. Choose string. Click on this arrow and you will notice all the options below the box, and you can select any relevant option. Am I clear up till here? Yes, 10th class. Is the concept of combo box clear? Arman, Okay. Now I'll be unmuting you one by one and I'll be asking few questions just to know that how much lecture you people have understood. All right. My first question is for Jayaditya. Jayaditya, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
In how many ways we can create the buttons?
Sir, repeat the question.
In how many ways we can create the buttons? Submit button can be created in how many ways?
Two
ways. Can you name the two ways?
Sir, one.
Which two tags are used to create the submit button?
Two tabs to create the submit button.
Yes. Input tag and button tag. All right, this question is for Japleen. Japleen, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Japleen, you tell me, if I want to create the multiple line box, which tag I have to use?
Repeat the question, sir.
If I want to create multiple line box, which tag I have to use? This multiple line box where I am typing the data.
Sir, text area.
Text area. Okay. This question is for Saksham. Saksham, unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Which tag is used to create the drop-down box? This drop-down.
Sir, repeat.
Which tag is used to create the drop-down box?
Select
tag. Very right. This question is for Chand. Chand, unmute yourself. Yes, Chand, unmute yourself. Chand, are you attending the lecture? Your name has been announced 3 times in the class. All right. Now, as you can see that I have created this drop-down box or the combo box. Now, when I display the browser view, you can see one option coming in the box initially. If you want that any particular option should always appear by default, so you can write the word selected in the opening tag of that option. Now this word selected, I have written in the science option. It means when the browser view will be displayed in the combo box, by default, science option will be highlighted. See here. First option was commerce. But I have selected the science option here. I have written selected keyword in front of science option. So science option will be appearing by default in the drop-down box. Similarly, if I write selected keyword in front of humanities, the humanities option will be appearing over there. see the browser view. Am I clear to all of you? The use of selected keyword. All right. Now this was your combo box. Suppose I want to create list box. When you create the list box, the scenario is totally same. No change is there. Only difference is you have to add one attribute in the select tag, and that with that attribute, your box will have scroll button and you can scroll through the list. Right now in the browser view, see, there is no scroll button. And you can select only one option among the given options. Now see the change I'm going to do. Size equal to 3. It means from the given options, only 3 options will be visible. In order to view the other options, you have to scroll through the list. I write one more option here. Graphics. Value equal to robotics. And I close the option tag. Now I have set the attribute size inside the select tag and I have given the value 3. It means from the given list, 3 options will be visible. And for the rest of the options, you have to scroll through the list. See here. 3 options are visible. For the rest of the options, scroll through the button. See here. I'm scrolling here. Am I clear with the list box? The difference in combo and list box is clear to all of you? Now, right now I can select one option. If you want to select multiple options, you write here the attribute multiple. Just write the multiple attribute over here. And now you can select multiple options. Science, press the control key. Arts, humanities. See, I am able to select more than one option from the given options by pressing the control key. Select one option, then press the control key from the keyboard, and you can select multiple options as per your convenience. Okay? Right? So if you want to create the list box, the coding is exactly same. Only you have to add the attribute size and whatever value you will provide here. According to that, the corresponding number of options will be visible. And to view the other options, you have to scroll through the list. Right? Now I have given 4 here. So 4 options are visible here. Okay? And for the other options, scroll through the list. Clear? Am I totally clear? And if I'm not giving the size and the multiple attribute, I am creating the drop down box or combo box. See here, Again, we are back to the drop-down box. Clear, all of you? Yes, 10th class. When you write the attribute multiple, it always creates the list box, not the combo. Okay, Arman? I'm displaying the notepad coding again. All of you go through the coding. Okay. So today you have learned how to create the text area, how to create the select file control, combo box, list box, and buttons. Right? I told you one more method to create the button, that is by using the button tag. Button type equal to submit. Okay. Submit here and close the button tag. This is another way to create the submit button. Okay. Button type equal to submit, name equal to whatever name you want to give. Write the name of the button here and close the button tag. Input tag is not closed, but button tag is container tag. You have to close it. Right? Am I clear to all of you?